Are you looking to grow your no-code consulting business? Well, if so, you might have already learned that email is the most powerful ally you have as you work on strengthening relationships with your potential customers. Well, in this video, I want to walk through my four favorite ways for capturing new folks to your email subscription list. And these are ways that are specific for no-code consultants. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where we have helped people get organized and automated with no-code tools like Airtable, SmartSuite, Zapier, and Make.com. This particular video, I want to talk to you about how you can yourself grow your own no-code consulting practice, whether you're coming at this as a freelancer or you want to build an agency like we have at Gap Consulting. In either case, email marketing is going to be a big, big component of how successful you are as you work with nurturing your relationship with clients over time. The reason for this, especially true for no-code consultants, is that in no-code consulting, the dollar amount spent is generally a little bit higher. And because of that, a lot of times when people first interact with your brand, they're not ready to buy right away. And so, how do you keep that engagement alive? How do you keep that relationship thriving over time? Email is one of your best ways of doing that because it's a direct line to your potential client who might not be ready to buy when they first meet you, but might be ready to buy from you in the future. Before I start talking about the different ways that I like to leverage to bring new people into our email list, I want to invite you to take my 5-day challenge. Whether you're just starting out or if you've been doing this for a bit already, it generally helps you to have a very strong foundation and to revisit that foundation every now and again. This 5-day challenge that I've put together is going to help you go through the basics and lead you to the point where you can feel confident making your first $1,000 online as a consultant. Check out that training and sign up at built2scale.io. That's the number 2. Without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this though and start talking about the 4 key ways that you can attract new people to your email list. And be sure to stick around until the end because the 4th one that I talk about is the one that I actually implemented myself when I was just starting out, and it is incredibly powerful. So, first and foremost, let's start with the call to action of an email crash course that you can provide for your potential clients. This is set up in such a way that you simply do an email capture on a web page and you say, hey, if you'd like to gain access to my crash course or to my email chain, you can sign up here. And what we wind up building in the background is a series of emails in what's called an email sequence that we'll start sending out on day 0, the day that somebody signs up, and we'll follow up with new emails every so often, whether you want that to be every day or every couple of days. And the idea here is that you're walking your new prospective client through a process, and the key takeaway is that you have to produce value for them during this sequence. So in my example, we started consulting in Airtable, and so we started working as an email crash course teaching people the very basic elements of Airtable. We walked them through the key components of the software over the series of 3 to 4 days. They would get an email a day over that period of time, and at the end of that time, they have been taken on a transition from never having seen the tool before to having a basic understanding of how it works. So that was the value that we were delivering in that particular case, and the reason that this worked so well is because the people that were signing up had already expressed to us a level of interest in Airtable. So this is the number 1 way that you can get started really easily. Just write a couple of emails, walking people through the basics of a particular thing that's gonna add value to your audience. Now, the second way that you can do this is by granting access to a community. I know a competitor of ours in the Airtable space that uses this exact strategy. They created a free community online in Slack, but you can use any of the multitude of tools available to you for community membership and management. Essentially, what you do here is similar to the first example, create a landing page where people can sign up, and upon signing up, they will be given an email that gives them access to your private community. This community can be free, or it might even carry a small dollar amount in order to get only interested parties in the community and help them stay engaged. In either case, you're offering the community support for somebody who's looking for something very specific. So of course you need to make your community relevant to your audience. In the case of my competitor who uses this strategy, they've created a community in Slack that is specific to Airtable and other no-code users. And so they've attracted hundreds, if not thousands, of different folks to that list. And of course, as everyone signs up, they are getting permission to market to that individual through their email list. So this is another great way for you to expand your reach and build your email list. Now, the third way is another very traditional way of marketing inside of email marketing. And this has to do with creating a handout for your potential client. So it could be something simple that gives them maybe a checklist that they have to go through when setting something up, or maybe a cheat sheet or a quick image or PDF that you might share. So something, again, that's relevant to your prospective clients that they will want to get in exchange for providing you with their email address. This way works fairly well, but because of the fact that it's less lengthy, less intense, and therefore less valuable than a lot of the other options that I've mentioned so far, this would be the lowest one on my priority list. But the advantage to this particular approach is that it's very quick and easy to set up. So if you're just starting out and you don't have the opportunity to commit a lot of time to this, you can quickly produce a simple PDF, stand that behind a landing page so that the PDF is available as soon as somebody provides their email address. And this is a great way for you to get up and running quickly. As I mentioned though, the drawback here is the fact that it's been done a lot over the years, and it's not incredibly valuable in the same way that email chains or community memberships might be. That takes us to our final opportunity here. And this is the one that I started with at Gap Consulting, and it worked incredibly well. But I have to warn you, it's also very time intensive for you as the business owner. And that is to offer your time up for a free consultation. I did this blocking out time in my Calendly, and I would block out 90 minutes every day. 3 30-minute consultations, and I gotta tell you, I was usually booked a week or two in advance, talking to 3 people a day, 5 days a week. Now, this is really advantageous, especially in your early days. And the reason that I think it's so powerful is because not only are you providing massive one-on-one value in this consultation, but also you are learning the problems that your clients are having. And in the early days of consulting, as you're building up your own freelance or agency, you're gonna not always be certain where your clients are coming from. You don't necessarily know what problems they're having because you haven't worked with enough clients to have that understanding yet. So this is a great opportunity for you to get a crash course of your own by working one-on-one with your clients in a free capacity. And the value here is their expectations are going to be relatively low because they're meeting with you during a free consultation. They haven't paid for anything, and the pressure is kept incredibly low for both parties. They don't feel like they have to commit to anything. It's a free consultation. You don't feel like you necessarily have to show up and perform at 120% because it's a free consultation. So the value here is you're providing incredible value one-on-one, and you're learning just as much from them as they are from you. Now, one thing that kept me really hesitant in the early days for doing this myself was I was worried that I wouldn't be able to provide enough value. So if you find yourself feeling the same way, let me give you this one piece of advice before I sign off. And that is simply to say that if you can help your client for free with one simple thing that they didn't know before, then they have not wasted their time with you. And so I made it my goal when hopping on those free consultations just to help them uncover one new truth about the software, about their work environment that they didn't know before. And if I could help just with one small thing in a 30-minute time block, their time was not wasted with me, and I felt like I delivered. The fact that I was able to grow my business using that methodology substantially in the first few years is, I think, all the proof I need to know that this worked incredibly well. I know we went super fast in this video, so if you have questions, feel free to drop them below. And as I mentioned, if you're looking to make your first $1,000 online in a no-code consulting space, check out that free training I mentioned. That's it for this video. If you want to check out more content like this, be sure you've subscribed to the channel, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.